Pravarpati. Welcome back to the channel. Today we have a fun art gallery, the Rachel, where we only show you the finest art in this world. Dali, Da Vinci will be quaking in their graves to see at this beautiful artwork they made. Not really. That art sounds like great, but I thought it might be fun to show you my art portfolio from high school, and then I did do art school for a little bit in college, and then just show you some random things I've done within the last couple of years after I decided to not continue doing my art major. Hopefully this is fun to see, isn't too boring, so let's get into it with my high school work. So here's some random pieces that our art teacher has to do to like practice certain things like watercolor or colored pencil, things of that different media nature. So the first one I have is this guy. Hopefully I'm putting it into frame because I actually have no idea. This is a scratch board, in case you guys don't know what that is. If you scratch it, it's white underneath. Scratchboard's pretty cool, but it's one of those things where it's, if you mess up, you can't take it back. So you just gotta roll with it.
Yes.
You'll notice I did a lot of animals in my art. And then now I'm trying to focus more on people because I'm trying to get better at drawing people. So you'll kind of notice that shift. The next project that I'm gonna talk about is where our teacher had us pick a skeleton that I wanted to draw. And when I was in high school, I thought that was weird, but now I think it's awesome. So I wanted to pick a skeleton that looked most like the animal, if animal is alive. Why was I different back then? So I did a swordfish. I think this was those pastels. So watercolor is a tricky little thing. So he had us practice some cherries using watercolors. This one's supposed to be more realistic, this one's supposed to have like a more abstract feel. Watercolor. I like it better now, but it's still not my favorite. Another project our teacher had us do was we had to transform a realistic image into a more abstract and more abstract and more abstract looking image at the end. So like for me, I did a cheetah, so I don't have that picture anymore, but I had like a normal cheetah, and then you slowly made it more abstract. Then you picked the one you liked most and then made it into a actual piece of art. The media for this one is Sharpie and colored pencil. Here's how it turned out. Actually, like it. I'm not really a huge fan of abstract art, but this is kind of an exception. I don't know. Kind of reminds me of like the 80s or something, but I like it, so that's why I kept it. And just to let you guys know, this is not all my artwork from high school. I threw a lot of it away because I just didn't like it. And for me personally, I barely like any of my artwork. I don't really think I've loved like 2 pieces that I've ever made. And that's not very many, so. Is anyone else like that with their artwork where they're like, oh, that's terrible, but then everyone's like, what are you talking about? Sounds good. But like, I feel like people like me are like our worst critic, which I don't think is a bad thing, but it can kind of be a bad thing. But I'm rambling. The next one I have is when they made us do a self-portrait. I hate doing self-portraits. Do not like self-portraits at all, but for some reason everyone always wants you to do a self-portrait, so alas, self-portrait. This is all done in colored pencil. And I want to do like a weird angle. I don't know. 10th grade self, or whatever this is made, so. There we go. Now I'm just safe about this one. I also got done with my artwork rather quickly, so I actually had time to make this extra piece. This one is getting made out of colored pencil, and I love dolphins a lot, so bam! We got a dolphin on colored pencil. Woohoo, I guess. Moving on into the art pieces that were all part of my AP collection. Now with your AP art collection, you have to like focus on a certain theme. So I really like Salvador Dali. Mine's a surrealist kind of thing, and they're all objects set in the desert. And what I did was I did one human-made object at least one, and then one nature object, like an animal or a tree or whatever, and I combine them together to kind of showcase how humanity is affecting nature. I know, really deep, right? So here's one. This one I feel like is most snowy. Like, I have a cloth, that's the human-made element, and then I have a moth. Yeah, and I just put these little, like, cloth tick marks on the sides. I don't know. Something extra, I guess. And this one was one of my favorites out of this whole series. Here we have a door and some fish and a little manta ray, and they're all kind of like sneaking out this door in the middle of the desert. I thought it was, I thought it was kind of clever. Oh, and we had to pick one media, or at least I did, and it's all chalk pastel for all of these surreal list. Surrealism pictures. This one kind of got smudged over time because they're like 10 years old now. But here is a snake coming out of the TV to show like the snakiness of media. Yes, I'm very deep. Always about being kind of rambly. You know, it's just one of those days where you feel like talking all the time and you just keep talking and no one really cares what you're talking about, and then you just keep feeling yourself. Yeah, that's the day today. I think this was the first one I made out of the series, and it's a giraffe drinking out of an egg. Cooked egg. That's the human element, because it's a cooked egg. And it's just drinking out of it. Hopefully you can see it, because I don't know if this plastic makes a big glare. A lot of people seem to like this one. It's two deep sea creatures, and they're the ones who use like the bioluminescence to create light, so I did that for like the anglerfish creating another light bulb out of a string of light bulbs, and then I wanted to also include this guy. It kind of reminded me of Beetlejuice or something, Tim Burton-esque, kind of like popping out of the desert. I guess it's Beetlejuice the most out of a Tim Burton movie. Oh yeah. Super grand. I think that's all the artwork I kept from high school. Moving on to my artwork from college. Now my art career in college wasn't very long. I think I only had 4 classes total with art, and 2 of them are history. And I think I did a drawing class, and then I don't remember the other class I've done. Don't know why I can't remember. But anyways, moving in to the first one. I'm actually pretty proud of this piece. Again, like I've said, I'm not the best with people. This is actually the first picture I made that actually, in my opinion, looks good for being a portrait of someone. So we had to pick a, I think like monochromatic color scheme, so I did like browns. And I like this one because it kind of reminds me of Star Wars. And it's of our friend Steve-O. I remember I was drawing this when he was playing video games, which is why he has that like intense look on his face. I do like that piece a lot. So that's why I've kept it, obviously. The last piece I kept from my art program in college was this one. The project was, we were supposed to do a piece inspired by someone's graffiti. So I personally am not a big fan of word graffiti, so I tried looking up an artist that did, I don't know, like picture graffiti. I found this Australian artist, I don't remember her name. She did some pretty cool stuff. So this was a piece that was inspired by her, and then I just put it on a background with like a bike in front of it. And I think the media, this one I just colored pencil. Moving on to random pieces I have, because I try and still do art outside of like the school atmosphere, although it's not as easy because I don't really have as much motivation to create art. Here are a couple that I have. This one is just like a random fox that's really happy and is wearing a bow tie. And I think the balloon kind of ruined it, but oh well. Again, I'm not really going to get into the technical art side of like what I could have done better on a piece. It's just showing you guys my art throughout the ages. Next is just this random antler with roses and crystals. One is this like gigantic jellyfish in space. I think it looks kind of cool. do apprenticeship essentially. And so I started trying to do a better job of doing like girls in kind of like a neo-traditional fashion. So you'll notice this theme a lot when I move into more of like the smaller artisans I work on. Here was like a bigger scale piece that I tried doing with that style. Oh yeah, this is all smudgy now. This has been moved around a lot, so it's smudged. And I don't think I did a very good job of like using this stuff that you can spray on to make it like stick better to the paper once you're finished with like the project. So this was a Benner Karabat with Kong because I had a huge crush and still do have a huge crush on Benner Karabat who plays Kong because he was like a fan in that movie. Alright, so moving on to a piece that I like actually painted with acrylic paint. This took me quite a while, and I think I was inspired by, because I started becoming more into the whole dark gothic-y stuff, and then I also was watching a lot of Attack on Titan, so that kind of like smooshed together into the painting. But here it is. I kind of want to do more pictures in this style of like this, can't remember what period of art it's where you see a lot of that style of portraits. I can't remember what era it is. Renaissance? Neo-Renaissance? I don't know. I can't remember. Moving into the pictures I started drawing because I wanted to do an apprenticeship at a tattoo shop, and again I wanted to do the neo-traditional style. Here's one of them. It's a fox, obviously. Here's another one. It's a snake with a dagger. And a similar one to the fox one. It's just like a bunny floating in the air. And I did a red panda. Oh, here's the fox one actually finalized. I forgot I drew the little clouds that I drew inspiration from with like Mulan, like their clouds look like that, and same for Hercules, look like more round and puffy. And same with like Avatar the Last Airbender. Here is this bat. I don't think you could probably tattoo this. I think it's too finely detailed, but I just wanted to have like its wing look like lace. And then I drew a Dapper Mouse, so I like to call him, kind of like a Sherlock Holmes almost style with the British teacup, and then him holding a tea bag, kind of like how you would hold a cane. To me, it looks kind of like a John Watson wearing a mouse. And I drew like this Halloween one where someone's squeezing a pumpkin. Then I started doing more people instead of like animals. This one is probably my favorite one. Like, I would possibly get this tattooed. Like, not, that's not the physical, but I mean, like, this is one where if I was like a client, I might want to get this one tattooed onto myself. Then I started drawing like more creepy girls. So this one is a girl in a candelabra with like a raven foot. The hand's not super proportional, but it's not terrible. And I drew this girl with like bat clips in her hair and then like a spider web glove. This one is another one of my favorites. It's like a witchy looking girl that was kind of like Sleeping Beauty. Didn't actually do that when I made it. And she had like crystals and then a cat. And then I went like this potion bottle. And I tried doing one where we did with watercolor because I heard that watercolor is most similar to what tattooing is like. So then I did this one with watercolor. It's a raven and a bat fighting for like these crystals and pearls. So thank you guys so much for watching and going through the art gallery de my channel. Hopefully you liked some of these pieces and maybe they might give you some inspiration for like certain artwork that you might want to do. Let me know if there was a favorite piece that you liked out of this whole gigantic compilation of artwork. Be prepared for a couple DIY videos now that I'm out of school for a couple of weeks of actual time to do them. Be prepared for two spooky-licious ghostly haunts videos coming to a screen near you. Have a awesome but spooky week, and I will see you in the next video.